In this video, we're going to commit random acts of destruction and learn a few things about capacitors along the way. So recently, an electronic gold mine had a great deal on some ultracapacitors, and I bought a whole bunch of them. Ultracapacitors are like regular capacitors, except they can hold much more energy. Here's an example. This is a 560 microfarad, 200 volt electrolytic capacitor, and it's about as big as you'll ever see on a consumer circuit board. The energy stored in a capacitor is given by this formula. If I apply it to this capacitor, I can see that it can store a maximum of 11.2 joules. In certain circumstances, that's enough to do some serious damage. Now, the ultracapacitors I bought are 2,600 farads, and that's not a mistake, 2,600 farads, with a maximum of 2.5 volts. That means that one of these ultracapacitors can store 8.1 kilojoules of energy, which is a ridiculous difference. So let's see what a few kilojoules can do. Here I have the ultracap charged to 2.35 volts, and you can already see, this thing means business. Let's start out by burning some soldering braid. Now let's melt an inductor. Here I'm shorting the cap across a 5-cent coin.
Whoa.
Wow, that beaver really took a pounding. And I thought it was fun to make these PCB traces light up like glow wire. Finally, let's make some random sparks again, just for the hell of it. And you know what's crazy? After all that, the cap is still charged to 1.7 volts. If you apply the capacitor energy storage equation before and after blowing things up, you can see that I used up 3.4 kilojoules of energy. So there's a lot left over. Now you might be wondering, how did I do all that with just 2 volts? If you take two AA batteries and put them in series, you get 3 volts with 2.5 amp hours of capacity, which is equivalent to 27 kilojoules of stored energy. That's more voltage and more capacity than the ultracapacitor has, and yet there's no way you could do all the things I just did with a pair of AAs. So what's the difference? The answer is a non-ideal property called equivalent series resistance, ESR for short. Batteries, capacitors, and a lot of other electronic components will have a small internal resistance, which limits the amount of current that can flow. For a typical AA alkaline battery, the equivalent series resistance is 120 milliohms. When you put a load on the battery, this resistance will cause a drop in voltage, and it'll generate heat within the battery. For example, a low-power device like a TV remote control might draw 20 milliamps. This would cause a 2.4 millivolt drop, which is nothing, and generate 48 microwatts of heat in the battery, which is also trivial. But if I try to draw 10 amps from the battery, there will be an internal voltage drop of 1.2 volts, and 12 watts of heat will be generated within the battery. So at higher currents, the battery voltage is unreliable, and things get hot enough to be very unsafe. Now let's see how the ultracapacitor would perform. This cap has a staggeringly low ESR of 0.7 milliohms. So with a 10 amp load, the internal voltage drop is 7 millivolts, and only 70 milliwatts of heat are being generated. That's nothing. Even at 100 amps, there's only a 70 millivolt drop, and 7 watts of heat are being generated. For a capacitor this big, that's not an issue. So you can see that because of the extremely low ESR, these ultracapacitors can charge and discharge hundreds of amps, no problem. So anyway, I'd say that was pretty impressive for a 2 volt supply. Now let's see what happens with a higher voltage. If I put 4 of these ultracaps in series, the maximum voltage becomes 10 volts. With a higher voltage, I can dump more power into a given resistive load. More power means bigger explosions. Here's what the capacitor array looked like wired up. But when I tried to charge it up, I ran into a bottleneck. My bench power supply is limited to 5 amps, and for caps this big, it's going to take a really long time to charge them up. Since I have some time to kill, let's estimate how long it'll take using this handy formula. 5 amps divided by 650 farads gives me a charge rate of 7.69 millivolts per second. Since I want to charge my array up to 10 volts, 10 volts divided by 7.69 millivolts per second equals 21.7 minutes. Okay, now we're at 9.65 volts, and let the fun begin! Ooh, this is gonna be good. Well, the PCB traces aren't melting anymore, now they just vaporize. And it turns out that the insulation on magnet wire is flammable. I didn't know that. Let's try it with 10 cents.
Whoa.
Looks like this ship has sailed.
Finally, let's vaporize a nail. And after all that, the caps were still charged to 9.33 volts. If I use the same energy storage formulas as before, you can see that I used up about 2 kilojoules of energy. In conclusion, ultracapacitors are awesome, and if you care about safety, don't do anything I did in this video.